I guess in a few sentences, what did this project mean to me? I think that this project meant showing people that a school for children with disabilities is not all we are. We're creating a future for these students. We're thinking ahead and we're preparing them for what's next, for high school, for beyond, for day-to-day life. It's not about just doing an art project and helping someone do an art project and everybody saying, wow, that was fun. It's about being a catalyst for independence, for them to go off and do it on their own. And for that moment when they walk into that art gallery and they said, Mom or Dad, this is my art and I worked really hard on it and you're gonna be really impressed. This is a great way for our students to express themselves. It's a great way to show people what we do at PG Chambers. It's a great opportunity for artists to show what they're capable of. What keeps coming back to me is that when we all work together, we can get something this great. There is no one person that would ever be able to put this together because everyone pitched in and everybody gave it their all. We got the results that we have now.
In 1954, the school was actually founded with community roots and by families who had children with special needs, and they needed educational programs and therapy services and a community. That's how we began, and we are certainly one of the most unique schools.
For a parent, it's just a wonderful experience. The people here really care about the children, and not just on the surface. It's a very deep and committed caring that they have. You feel welcome every single time you walk in to the building. And on top of that, their educational program here is wonderful.
PG Chambers School offers education and related therapy services to children with multiple disabilities from ages 3 to 14. We've recently started a high school program for our 14-year-olds as well.
Our mission is to provide those services that are needed in the community
to develop that love of learning with students and have them to be the best that they can be.
Right now we have 119 children in the school program alone. We offer a multitude of other services.
We've had musicians come in and artists come in, but in this way, this program was very different.
It was a true collaboration and an interaction with the students and the artists. And it was very, very open-ended. I think in the past we've had artists in residence, but it was more they were teaching. There wasn't that interaction. With this project, the end seemed like it was the beginning.
My name is Rebecca Jampel, and I am the director of Solo's Project House, which is the gallery involved with PG Chambers in this program. I guess I can say that I'm part of the visionary team for this program. I was approached by Ryan Ahern, who works with PG Chambers. He's an occupational therapist there, years ago, about possibly integrating special needs programming.
That was literally 2 years before the project actually started, because Rebecca came with Ryan Ahern, one of our occupational therapists, with an idea. They said, we have this idea to do an art mentorship program. And it really was just that.
So with the help of Ryan, we actually created the program together, and that's how this began.
Special things like an art mentorship program is not within our school budget. So my role was to find funding, and actually it was very simple because I went to one of our key donors, Susan Gordon. She does have a very strong interest in the arts to begin with. And when I explained the project to her and thought she might do some partial funding, she was very pleased to actually fund the entire project. So the funding went from no funding to being completely funded.
What I always wanted from this project from the start was that to really incorporate the feeling of working at PG Chambers, this connectedness, this passion to push for independence for our students, and for that emotion to come across as much as it was for the artwork to be great. What I saw was that the students had something on a Friday afternoon that they were looking forward to. And I heard students saying from the first week, Sarah said to Nicole, Nicole was showing her art to Sarah so she could help them understand what her art looked like, and she said, your art is so artsy, and just these, I wanted the students to feel comfortable, I wanted the artists to feel comfortable, and we wanted everybody to have the feeling that we have working here at PG Chambers, because if it's not comfortable and fun, then why would anybody do it?
Hi, my name is Susan Gordon, and it's been a pleasure to support the art mentorship program between PG Chambers School and the Solos Project House.